Hey guys, it's Ingrid with Care Tootie, and I know it's been a while. You guys might not know because I have videos that are stacked up, so I'll be recording them, but the reason there was a big lull in my channel for a while was because I was trying to get caught up with swaps and life in general. And so here I'm back. Yay! I am so excited to be sharing this project with you. It is a loaded envelope swap that I actually hosted on Loaded Envelopes Galore on Facebook. And this one was Marie Antoinette. And I have been a big fan of anything to do, anything French, anything Versailles, but especially Marie Antoinette. And if any of you saw the movie by Sofia Coppola, that the Marie Antoinette, where Kristen Dunst plays Marie, it's so great because we through history we hear like how, you know, horrid she was, and you know, she spent all this money on clothing and stuff, but what no one really stops to think about is that she was 12 years old when she got married. She was 18 years old when she was ruling France, which was a powerhouse in the world at that time. And she wasn't even French. She was from Austria and got stripped of everything to go there. So if you haven't seen that movie, I highly recommend it. I love it. It's one of my favorites. When I craft, I have the DVD and I throw it in the computer and watch that. So anyway, so here we are. First, I guess I'll try to lift it up. Hopefully I'm going to be in frame. I've taped a couple videos where I wasn't. So frustrating. So I did this one a little different. I backed up two loaded envelopes to each other using Scrap the World's tutorial. So see how you see here, there's one and two. And so I didn't know what the front and the back is. So they're both the front and they're both the back. So originally this was my my front, but I think that with the pink color scheme here, it looked better with this being the front. So anyway, so here we go. Oh, and I should say this swap is with Pink Scrapper and Carlene, and I'm gonna list her. You guys probably already know who she is because she's amazing. So I'm gonna list her channel down below. But anyways, we'll start with this doll, literally doll, and this is using one of Robin. Do you guys remember the video that I did, the Valentine swap from Australia? She had sent me over a package of these beautiful clothespins. And so, thank you, Robin. So now I get to use them. But I created this doll for her, and I actually backed it on a straw so she can use it, you know, if she wants to display it in her room. And what I did is I found this printout, or this printable, on, I think it was on Pinterest, but I'm not sure. And I printed it out on cardstock, and then I backed it onto chipboard. So it's heavy. And then for the hinges, I just used some little metal brads, and I thought that was so cute. And then for the skirt, I just took some fabric, as you can see here, and then I just layered it with ribbons and trim. Here she is. And then I did a oh, and this trim right here, do you guys remember this? This was from Michelle Randolph when we did the wand swap. She had gifted me that, so I used that. And then some seam binding. You know, it's funny because I watch videos and I always wonder, how do people remember who gave them what? But you kind of do. I'm saying that now, but of course next video I'll forget. So there we go. So here's my doll, and this was like the showstopper for it. I love this. I've been wanting to do a doll. I knew. Oh, and actually, I'll show you guys real quick. Hang on. This might be helpful. Hang on, if I was organized. This might be helpful for you guys, maybe. When I plan out a loaded envelope, I can just make it, you know, and then I feel like I have so many thoughts in my head, and I don't know. So what I did was I had two which I'll be filming back to back, the two loaded envelopes that I have, the one with Carlene and then the other one with Celeste. And I just did sketches of what I thought would be, you know, I would want to do. Here's what I wanted to do, to want, whatever. And I'm still going kind of liberal on this. So meaning if, like, for example, I wanted to do this mask, but it ended up not happening. And instead I did this doll. I just felt like, that kind of, I don't know, it, I like that one better. And so this is kind of what I did. And this helps me. I keep this, open next to me so that I can look and see what it is, and it kind of gives me ideas. And so, like, let's say I have a pin board that, if you guys follow me on Pinterest, I believe it's Kara Tudy, but it's probably Ingrid Carlson. Remember Carlson with an E at the end, or E-N. And I have like a pin board, and I have one that's loaded envelopes vintage, loaded envelope swaps. I might have another one. I don't know, but I have a lot of pin boards. So I have a lot of scrapbooking, decorating, all kinds of stuff. So if you want, go check me out. But anyhow, so I'll go on there and I'll grab ideas that I like. So for example, if you guys look in my pin board, I have, one that was, I think it's like an Alice in Wonderland, wand. And so that's kind of where I got this idea. And so anyway, so you guys can see, and then I just jot it down here. I like just, you know, do it like a very quick, fast sketch of it. And this helps me out a lot. So hopefully that'll help you planning. And especially if you have a lot of swaps that you're doing, if it's not just like one after another, that really helped me out because I was in a bind. I had a bunch stacking up. So, I think that the back, front, whatever, this side is my favorite. I love these, you know, artist renditions of Marie. This one I love. It's just so pretty and pink and soft and, like whimsical. And then I just hand wrote Queen on it on some cardstock. I backed it up on, I think there's two doilies here that are interlocked. And then a heart doily, and then she's on top there. And then I layered it with some crepe paper on the back. And then inside I did this little tiny little lollipop wand. And I just made a rosette using some crepe paper, a cutout using, it's a die that I have for my Big Kick, another die, and a little enamel sticker from, or little heart, whatever, from Target. And then here is one of, all my tags are in here. So this is the first of three. And again, just love this image. Here's a rosette using crepe paper. I sewed around the edge of the whole thing and then just created a cluster here with some beautiful, and I lost the name, Prima papers, more of that, the heart doilies that I think I got from Hobby Lobby, and then some more, this is a Tim Holtz, no it's not, oh I can't remember the dye, but it's a, I was going to get the Tim Holtz and then decided for this one, and then I use this Stamen, is that what you guys call this, I don't even know, but I thought that that looked kind of cute, and then like I said, just layered it. This has some pop dots to give it some dimension. So I'll put that one there. Then here's another one, completely different. It's funny when you look at images of Marie, there's all kinds of different images, and then you just wonder, what did she really look like? I think that this is the truest to what, sorry, I have like this fuzz from this rug thing. I think this is the truest rendition. This is her face, but I don't know. Anyways, I thought that this one was beautiful with that beautiful hat. I mean, her clothing, so fabulous. Here I took some trim. They're like rose trim. Oh, and then on here too as well, I forgot to note that I did just splatters with the, watered down gesso. And then you can see it more here because the paper is darker. And again, I just did a cluster again with the, I followed the same technique here on both flowers. I kind of tried to mimic everything the same, just different pictures, different papers, but it was kind of the same idea. And then this one, and this is just using the bigger of the dies, another picture of her. And this paper, as well as all three of these papers in the background, the big papers, are, oh my goodness, Anna Griffin. Griffith? Oh, I always get that confused, sorry. This one you guys saw me do from Target Dollar, no, it's not, it's from Dollar Tree. It was a like a bushel of these, but I thought it was cute in there. And then now let's go to the back front. So I made this little clip here and I just distressed this paper clip. It's a blue paper clip and then I just did some gesso on it. This is like a foamy flower that I got from AliExpress with some trim on the back here. And then inside here, let me pull this stuff out real quick. So you can see with the envelope, I used some Prima papers, and then I don't remember the rest of them, sorry. But we'll start down here. I did a cluster of flowers. So here was that die that you saw me using in the tags. And then I just layered the large flowers and then a smaller one in the middle, and I attached it with a gold brad. Then I have some pink tulle layered on some doilies, and then on top, this flower was from the Michael's Valentine's, I believe, Recollections package, and then some that I got at AliExpress, or they could be Wild Orchid Crafts, I'm not 100% sure. And then another one of these foam flowers, this one, but then I just used some Angel Mist and some other, maybe the Heidi Swap Color Shine, and to make it match better so it didn't stick out. Same with these. These were white flowers, and then I, you know, put stuff on them. And then I put, when I finished, that watered down gesso on the edges, as you can see here. And then this is some trim that I've had for a long time, and then also some lace in the back here. So that first pocket has this little envelope that I made. Here's the Maggie Holmes digifile, another die cut, and then this was just a book that I have that I use for that, and I'm just gifting her some flowers. And then here I made her some their flowers using a mold and a glue gun. And so there, I don't know if I can open it or not. Oh, I can. Give me one sec. Let me get off frame for just a minute. Okay, so you can see them here. So, and I just put some paper behind here. This is like a little Ziploc baggie. And then I added a little bow just to make it cute. And then another little baggie. And I'm not gonna open this. I'll just tell you guys what's in it. I just used a deli bag and then some shearing scissors, sorry, to make this little envelope. And then I am gifting her a die that I got from AliExpress. And here's a little bag of goodies, and they're just some, let's see. I always say, okay, I'm not gonna go through the whole thing and open it, but I know that I like to see everything so that it gives me ideas of what I wanna do, so I'll go ahead and share it with you guys. So I just did some printouts on cardstock of some beautiful Marie-styled dresses, and then some little head pieces. And so I just stuck them in here. And I thought these would be great pieces, even if not just Marie. I know that she likes shabby chic stuff, and so I thought it would be a good, you know, something that she could use in other projects. So I'll tie that. Okay. little tags, big tags. Okay, we'll start with the wands. So here is a wand, and I don't remember who inspired me to do this. It might have been Lisa from Paper Passions. I think it was, because she finished her wands off on both sides. So I wanted to do one like this. I have this, I think it's originally a snowflake, and it's made out of, it's like a very thick felt, if you guys can see, with more of that trim, and then a doily, and then on the front, that paper that you guys saw me use in this tag, a die cut, some flowers, a little banner, and then this is a Heidi Swap. It's like an acetate piece, and it says flirt. And I thought that was cute. Here's my mega wand. This was my the one that I knew that I wanted to make. So I'll kind of go over it really quick. Some crepe paper, a doily, just a round punch out of this beautiful rose with gold foil paper. Then I clustered some other, I think it's Prima paper in the background, a die cut that I believe that this one came from my Silhouette, another beautiful image of Marie, that trim that I've used, the stamens. Someone tell me, am I saying that right? Maybe it's stamen. I don't know. It's the middle of the flower. So, and then this paper flower that also was with the Recollections from Michaels. And then on the back, it has that beautiful gold paper. And these straws, aren't they adorable? I got these at TJ Maxx. One day I was checking out, and they were, you know, at the front in that line section there where you, I think that's it, where you are gonna go check out when you stand in line. They have all those goodies there to try to get you to buy them. And I'm the sucker that always buys them. But I bought them out, all the ones that they had, I bought. Also on the envelope, I did some crepe paper in here, and I added this little key, and I believe this is the Paper Studio from Hobby Lobby. And then this piece is from, I believe, Tim Holtz. And this was a little rosette that I added. I put it on a paper clip and distressed it. So you can kind of see here now the envelope empty. The envelopes, I guess there's two. So you can see. Okay. And then I gifted her some of the little rosettes. I got those at Hobby Lobby. And then I have this little flower. It's a Prima flower that Lisa had gifted to me, and I distressed it with some gesso and added it on a gold paper clip. And then lastly, but not least, are three more little tags. And I love little tags. And then I just layered. This is an image that I got on Pinterest, a flag, some, I don't know if that's Prima paper or not. I don't remember. And it's all backed on white cardstock and then sewn. And I love these like little dangle pieces. Here is the heart doily. And I actually cut it in half. Can you guys see that there? And then I added it like that. I'm not even sure why I did it, but I did. Here's the flag. I just hand cut a heart, and then this one says France, so this is Love France. And then the last one, oops, this should go down, another one of those flowers, see, that's the middle of the flower that I was talking about. And this one was also from Recollections from Michaels, and on this one I did a flag to match that heart, and it says Marie on it. And again, I just sewed around it and then layered it on some crepe paper that I gathered together. So that is my envelope. I hope that you guys like it. I hope that it brings you some inspiration, and mostly I hope that Carlene loves it. So I actually got hers in the mail, but I am waiting to open it until she gets mine. So I can't wait for her to get it. Now it can be out in the mail tomorrow morning, and I'm super excited. So thank you guys again for watching. Thank you for subscribing. And I will see you again soon. Bye-bye.